Do you take care of everyone else except yourself? Today we're going to discuss 8 ways to fortify your boundaries. Hi, this is Keri Stewart with Results for Business, and I'd like to share a story with you today about Richard. Richard loves to feel needed. As a kid growing up, and even in college, he felt drawn to the helping professions and found his deepest passion with a career in nursing. While he finds great fulfillment in his job, helping out at the community center on weekends and working with his aging parents doing things that they can't do for themselves, he recently noticed that he was starting to feel some resentment because people would continuously call needing something. They would stop by, unannounced, asking for favors, and he would give up all of his free time doing things for them, leaving no time for himself. If this sounds anything like you, it might be time to start setting stronger boundaries to help you reclaim your time and self-esteem. Let's first look at how we get to this point of being too available, too helpful, or too accommodating. Is it that you enjoy pleasing others, even if it takes precedence over what you want and what you need? Over time, did an expectation grow that you'd always say yes, and now you have become a reliable well of support and on call for your friends and family? So what do you do now? After all, everyone relies on and needs you, right? Well, first, let's start with some compassion for yourself and others. This is a common issue in relationships, and you can shift it. Second, decide the qualities you'd like in your relationships. In a healthy adult relationship, each person takes responsibility for themselves, has several resources to get their needs met, can ask the other person for help, can say no without fear of punishment, can say yes only when yes is meant and comes without resentment. Thought number 3, give yourself a buffer. If someone asks a favor, don't say yes or no right away. Tell them you'll get back to them. Number 4, discover what's important to you. How do you want to grow and use your full potential? Keep that foremost in your mind as a filter for when and how you say yes or no to others. Number 5 is set limits on how you help other people. Practice saying no or not now. Notice how it makes you feel to set boundaries and take responsibility for yourself. Number 6, give others a chance. Saying no gives others an opportunity to step up. Number 7, how about if you ask others for support? Ask people to respect your new boundaries. Tell them, when can they call you? When can they come by? What constitutes an emergency? Make your relationships equitable. Ask for support and help on your projects. Idea number 8, create physical boundaries. Shut the door and put a do not disturb or out to lunch sign or office hours. Put a sign on it. Let people see other types of clues that you can give them about stepping into your personal space. When do they need to stay out? Setting and maintaining boundaries gets easier with practice, and you can still help others who need and appreciate your support. But don't forget Covey. You have to take care of the golden goose first. By taking care of yourself first, then you can take care of everybody else. What can you do right now to fortify your boundaries?
Thank you for watching. If you're on YouTube or iTunes, please subscribe. For more information, visit us at resultsforbusiness.net, where you can see other great videos and access cutting-edge coaching and training to help you and your business.